frequency. How to find out a frequency when mean is given? In the previous classes, we studied how to calculate mean by direct method, assumed mean method, and step deviation method when all the frequencies were given. But here you can see one frequency is missing and mean is given. Using this, we are going to calculate the value of f. You can see the classes are of equal length, hence we prefer step deviation method. The headings for step deviation method is: third column is mean value, fourth column is ui, which is xi minus a upon x, and the last column is fi, ui. We know how to calculate xi, which is the mean value. It is sum of these two numbers divided by 2, which gives 10. Similarly, we get the mean value of the second class, 30, and 50, 70, 90 for the remaining 3 classes. Here, marking of ui is usually when the mid values are given, we take the center value as the assumed mean. But here, when frequency is the same, we take xi corresponding to f as the assumed mean. Once again, I explain, f is missing here, its corresponding xi should be taken as the assumed mean. And we know how to calculate h. H is the size of the class. This is calculated from the first class. You can see the 0 to 20, 20 to 40, 40 to 60, they are equal and the difference gives what, 20. Therefore, the value of h is what it is, 20. Therefore, the first ui entry is xi. Xi is 10 here minus assumed mean, which we have marked as 70, divided by h. Size of the class is 20. It gives minus 3. Similarly, we get for the remaining classes minus 2, minus 1, 0, and 1. The last class is fi, ui. It is the product of fi and ui. We know fi is the second column and ui is the fourth column. So, multiplying these two columns, we get entries for fi, ui. So, 8 into minus 3 gives minus 24. 15 into minus 2 gives minus 30. Similarly, we get here minus 20, 0 and 5 respectively. While combining this, you can observe minus numbers are there, zeros there and positive numbers are there. So here, combining these three negative numbers, we are getting minus 74 plus this 5 gives the total minus 69. We have to find out total of fi bottom called sigma fi. This total gives 48 plus f. Now let us use the formula for step deviation method. X bar equals a plus sigma fi ui upon sigma fi multiplied by h. X bar is given in the question as 47. A we have marked as 70. Total of sigma fi we have found as minus 69. Sigma fi is 48 plus f multiplied by the size of the class, which is 20. So here, because it is minus, I have brought this entire term to the left side, which becomes plus as 69 into 20 upon 48 plus f equals 70. 47 is brought this side, therefore it becomes minus 47. So this total becomes what? 23. Cross multiplying, this 23 comes down and 48 plus f go to the right side numerator. So solving this, we get f is equal to 16 minus 48. Therefore, the missing frequency f is 12. In this question, we are going to find out two frequencies which are missing. In the previous sum, we found only one frequency. But here, we are going to find out two frequencies, x and y. Here, two data are given. X bar is given and sigma fi. Using these two, we are going to calculate the values of x and y. You can see the classes are of equivalent length. Therefore, we are going to use here two step deviation method. As before, I get the headings xi, ui and fi, ui. Third column is mid value, which is the sum of these two numbers divided by 2, which gives 10, followed by 30, 50, 70, 90 and 110. Ui. Xi minus a upon h. psi of the missing frequency x. Otherwise, the entry corresponding to y also can be taken as the assumed mean. So we can choose either 30 or 70 as the assumed mean. Here I have taken assumed mean as 70. Therefore, ui, the first ui becomes xi 10 minus assumed mean. This 70 divided by 20, which gives minus 3, followed by minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, and 2. The last column is fi ui, which is the product of fi ui. 5 into minus 3 becomes minus 15, x into minus 2 becomes minus 2x. Similarly, we get minus 10, 0, 7, and 16. Here we have many categories. Minus numbers are there, 0 is there, plus numbers are there, and there is a term which is x. So x is a separate term, so I have written here minus 2x. Total of minus numbers becomes minus 25, and the total of plus numbers is plus 23. Solving this, we are getting minus 2 minus 2x. Also, I have formed total of this frequency column, which gives 30 plus x plus y. Y I have taken it is equal to 15. 15 is given in the question as a sigma fi. We know sigma fi is total of frequency column. Therefore, 1 total is 30 plus x plus y according to the column, and 1 is given in the question as 15. So, equating these two, we get x plus y is equal to 20. Let us go for the calculation. X bar is a plus sigma fi ui upon sigma fi into h. X bar is given in the question as 62.8. Substituting the values of a, sigma, fi, ui, sigma, fi, and h, we are getting all these numbers. So I have brought 72%, which becomes minus 70. So subtracting these two, we get minus 7.2 multiplied by this 5, which is equal to minus 4 minus 4x. So solving, we get x is equal to 8. This x plus y equal to 20 is copied from this column. Plus y is equal to 20. Substituting the value of x as 8 plus y gives 20. Therefore, y becomes 12. Therefore, the missing frequencies are x is equal to 8 and y is equal to 12. A small homework. Exercise 13.1. Third sum you can solve for one frequency. And if you want to remember the second example, please repeat the last example.